My name is Bruce Boehrer. The piece is 1650 degrees centigrade. This piece speaks to me because it taps into a long-standing fantasy of mine, a fantasy of self-immolation, as it were. I think of myself taking the elevator to the top of the state capitol, climbing out on top of it, and leaping off in a swan dive with the works of Milton in one hand, the works of Shakespeare in another, and a lit stick of dynamite up my fundament, crashing to the ground, 50 megames professor bomb. Here we have something very similar. Of course, the Acme rocket isn't actually shoved up the orifice in question, but it might as well be, if you think about it that way, and it has propelled the figure in the painting into a different world. Well, that's where we're headed, isn't it? I like to think of the dog being there. And I like to think of it also as all being accomplished by flatulence. On March 4th, 1607, Sir John Crook delivered a message to the House of Commons from the House of Lords on the subject of Scottish naturalization. And in response, a member of Parliament, Sir Henry Ludlow, released a great and sour fart, which, according to ear witness testimony, set the whole room to laughing and so put the speaker out of countenance that he was almost incapable of finishing his message. It is the power of flatulence, after all. Once again, here emanating into the literary sphere, entered into the proceedings of the House of Parliament and made subject of controversy and poetic descants for generations thereafter by a series of different poets, the most famous of them being Ben Jonson. And what of Laika? Has Laika been blown into this new world on the power of her own farts? Who would have to ask her?